إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ربي لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أعاذني الله وإياكم من البدع والضلالات والخرافات والشركيات. إخوة الإيمان والإسلام، يقول الله جل وعلا في كتابه الكريم: كنتم خير أمة، you're the best أمة، أخرجت للناس، that have been produced for mankind، تأمرون بالمعروف because you enjoy good، وتنهون عن المنكر because you forbid evil، تؤمنون بالله and you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَوْ آمَنَ أَهْلُ الْكِتَابِ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ. And if the people of the book had believed, it would have been better for them. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this book was written by one of the great scholars of Islam, Muhammad Jamil Zino. He was a teacher in Darul Hadith in Mecca almost 40 years. So I like this book, and I teach in our masjid the youth, men, women, children. It's beneficial book, very beneficial book. So the last question in the book says, متى ينتصر المسلمون? When will the Muslims be victorious over their enemies? When will they be victorious? So the Sheikh will answer to you. As you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There was darkness in the world. People worshiping idols, statues, worshiping the sun and the moon, animals, private parts of human beings. The strong tribe used to kill and rob for the weak tribes. They used to eat the dead and marry their maharim, their sisters and aunties and parents. Darkness. Using they used to worship a stone. If they find another stone which is more shining or more beautiful, they used to throw for their only God. And likewise. So my brothers, the Sheikh says, ينتصر المسلمون إذا رجعوا إلى تطبيق كتاب ربهم وسنة نبيهم صلى الله عليه وسلم وأخذوا بنشر التوحيد وحذروا من الشرك على اختلاف مظاهره وأعدوا لأعدائهم ما استطاعوا من قوة. قال الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن تنصروا الله ينصركم. The Shaykh is answering for that question. When will the Muslims be victorious? He said, the answer, when they return to the implementation of the book of their Lord, the Quran, and the Sunnah of their Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they spread the teachings of Tawheed, La ilaha illallah, when they learn and teach and spread Kalimatul Tayyiba, Kalimatul Tawheed, La ilaha illallah. Many Muslims, including me, we may say La ilaha illallah, but we do not understand the meaning of La ilaha illallah. Some may say La khaliqa illallah, there is no creation but Allah. Yes, it's true. But the non-Muslims, they know that there is no creation but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَلَئِن سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَهُمْ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ. If you ask them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who created you? They will say Allah. If you ask them who created the heavens and the earth, they will say Allah. If you ask them who is their savior, they know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They know Him. That's not the point. The point is, they do not understand the meaning of La, even that's why they reject it. إِنَّمْ كَانُوا إِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ. They rejected. It needs to be arrogant when they are called to believe لا إله إلا الله. Why? لِأَنَّهُمْ فَهَمُوا أَنَّ مَنْ قَالَ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ لَا يَعْبُدُ غَيْرَ اللَّهِ وَلَا يَدْعُو غَيْرَ اللَّهِ وَأَنَّ مَنْ قَالَ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ لَا يَذْبَحْ لِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ وأن من قال لا إله إلا الله لا يستعين فيما لا يقدر بغير الله ولا يستغيث لغير الله ولا يعتقد أن غير الله يضر أو ينفع. وإن يمسسك الله بضر فلا كاشف له إلا هو. So they understood that the person who says لا إله إلا الله will not call and ask help other than Allah for what he can't. Give me healing, give me children. He can't help you. So anyhow, they understood the meaning of La ilaha illallah, and that it means La ma'buda bihaqqin illallah, that there is no deity worthy of worship in truth except Allah. That's the meaning. Ma'na La ilaha illallah, أي لا معبود بحق إلا الله. There is no deity worthy of worship in truth. Yes, there are millions of fake and false gods that people worship beside Allah, but it involves it. لا معبود بحق إلا الله. There is no deity, there is no God worthy of worship in truth except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Proof from the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ذلك بأن الله هو الحق. That is because Allah is the truth. And he is the only one who has the right to be worshipped in truth. المستحق للعباد وحده لا شريك له. So, لا إله إلا الله means لا معبود بحق إلا الله. قال الله تعالى فاعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله. Know, O Muhammad, learn, understand, comprehend, O Muslim. That's the meaning. لأن الخطاب لمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم هو الخطاب لأمتي. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing to his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that is also for you. Except that Allah made special or specific to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Learn, ya Muslim, O Muslim. Know, O Muslim, that none has the right to be worshipped in truth. That there is no deity worthy of worship in truth except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَغَيْرُ اللَّهِ عُبِدَ فَبِبَاطِ And worshipping other than Allah, if it's worshipping other than Allah, it's falsehood. People, some worship Jesus, some worship Buddha, some worship the cow, some worship the dirham and the dinar, some worship their lusts and desires, some worship the private parts of human being, some in some parts of the world, they worship shaitan, devil. أَلَمَّ أَهَدِي إِلَيْكُمْ يَا بَنِي آدم لا تعبدوا الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين. Allah in the day of يوم القيامة saying وامتازوا اليوم أيها المجرمون separate أو criminals also committed major sins like shirk because that's the greatest sin in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إنه من يشرك بالله فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ So the Shaykh says, my brothers, when they return, they will be victorious when they return to the implementation of the book of the of their Lord, the Quran, and the Sunnah of their Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and spread the teachings of Tawheed, avoid all different forms of shirk. All forms of shirk. Associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا Worship Allah alone and do not associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ And you Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed, has commanded and ordained أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّا That you worship none but Allah alone subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا And be dutiful to your parents. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ تَعَالَوْا أَتْلُ مَا حَرَّمَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَيْكُمْ أَلَّا تُشْرِكُوا شَيْئًا So my brothers, that is a great sin. يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ That is the advice, the admonition of Luqman to his son. Oh my son, do not associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a major sin, it's a great sin. Allah forbade from entering Jannah for anyone who dies while he's upon shirk. إِنَّهُ مَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ Verily, whoever associates partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah forbade him from entering Jannah. So the prophets feared from shirk, their rituals feared from shirk, the Sahaba feared from associating partners from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even Prophet Muhammad feared disbelief after belief subhanahu wa ta'ala. He used to seek refuge in Allah from disbelief after beliefs. This is Ibrahim alayhi salam, Abu al-Anbiya, the father of the prophets, Khalil al-Rahman, the friend of Allah. Ibrahim alayhi salam, who destroyed all forms of shirk and all the idols and statues and false deities that his people used to worship beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَجَعَلَهُمْ جُدَادًا إِلَّا كَبِيرًا لَهُمْ Ibrahim, whom Allah Azza wa Jalla commanded his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to follow the footsteps of Ibrahim. ثُمَّ أُوحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ أَنِ اتَّبِعْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمِ We inspired you, revered you, Muhammad, that you follow the footsteps of Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ibrahim is a Muslim and his religion is Islam. Jesus Isa is a Muslim, his religion is Islam. Muhammad is a Muslim and his religion is Islam. Yaqub, Zakaria and his son Yahya, they are Muslims and their religion is Islam. Ibrahim and his two sons, Ismail and Ishaq, are Muslims. And the 12 descendants, 12 are Muslims. All the prophets and the messengers are Muslims and their religion is Islam. Inna ad-deena 'inda Allahi al-Islam. Verily the true religion in the sight of Allah is Islam. Inna Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept from anyone from other than Islam. وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whoever seeks a religion other than Islam, he will not be accepted. وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. And in the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, the day of judgment, the day of resurrection, the day of doomsday, the day of reckoning, Yawm al-Hisab, when all mankind will stand before their Lord Allah for reckoning, that day he will be among the losers, مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. And the khasara, or the losing, is not dunya. It is not losing your job or wife or child or your company or anything or health. It is losing. The real khasara is khasara to deen. قُلْ إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَهْلِهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. So the Sheikh says, Muslims will be victorious when they return to the implementation of the book of their Lord Allah, of Quran, and the sunnah of their Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when they spread the teachings of Tawheed, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, when they avoid all different forms of shirk and confront their enemies with all the power at their disposal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, wa'iddu lahum mastada'tum min quwwa. Allah says, prepare as much as you can, prepare for your enemies. And today, what is amazing, the Muslim countries, what they produce or what they make is, they have the industry of cigarettes, pasta, and matches, and the industry of the plastic bags, tobacco industry. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. And Allah says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, prepare even your body, prepare your body, prepare your muscles. But look, we cannot win our enemies by power and having weapons and cruise missiles and the mother of bombs and nuclear bombs. Look at the Sahaba. There were two superpowers in the world when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Persians, the empire of Persia, and the empire of Romans. But subhanallah, the Sahaba and Rasulullah defeated them with the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Good example of that is, وَلَقَدْ نَصَرَكُمُ اللَّهُ بِبَدْرٍ وَأَنْتُمْ أَدِلَّ. Allah gave you victory in the battle of Badr while you were weak. While you were weak. Why? Because of they obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They obeyed His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They stayed away and kept themselves away from all kinds of haram, all major sins and all minor sins. They were righteous people. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِن تَنْصُرُوا اللَّهَ يَنْصُرْكُمْ أَوْ يُمُؤْمِنِينَ. If you help me, the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will help you. If you do so, if you obey Allah and His Messenger, if you learn your deen, if you practice your deen, if you preach and invite others to your deen, if you are patient for the cause of La ilaha illallah, Allah will give you victory. But look, when they disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they disobeyed the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَيَوْمَ حُنَيْنٍ, the battle of Hunayn, they were very powerful. They were having all kinds of weapons. And a big number of men. They said, لَنْ نُغْلَبَ الْيَوْمَ مِنْ قِلَّةٍ. No one can defeat us today because of our power and the weapons. But they were defeated because of that. They forget Allah. وَيَوْمَ حُنَيْنٍ إِذَا عَجَبَتْكُمْ كَثْرَتُكُمْ. They were amazing. They were amazed and they were proud because of their big number. They were defeated for that battle. إِذَا عَجَبَتْكُمْ كَثْرَتُكُمْ فَلَمْ تُغْنِ عَنْكُمْ وَضَاقَتْ عَلَيْكُمْ أَنفُسُكُمْ بِمَا ثُمَّ وَلَّيْتُمْ مُدْبِرِينَ. Then Allah gave them His help. Allah aided them. So look, the Sahaba defeated the Mushrikeen in the battle of Badr. But look, Uhud. أولما أصابتكم مصيبة قد أصبتم مثليها قلتم أني هذا. They were almost 70 among them were killed because they disobeyed the order of Rasulullah. Stay here. Stay here. Don't move from here. They disobeyed Rasulullah. Khalid ibn al-Walid came from the back and defeated them. They said, أني هذا, how come this happened to us? Allah said, قل هو من عندي أنفسكم. It is that you eat because you did something wrong, because you disobeyed Allah and His Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. My brothers, let us obey Allah. واطيعوا الله واطيعوا الرسول. Let us obey Allah and let us obey Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. Let us follow the Quran and the Sunnah. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, عليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين. Follow my Sunnah and the Sunnah of my خلفاء. And Rasulullah said, whoever leaves after me will see a lot of differences. We'll see a lot of sects. A lot of groups. Each one is away from the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What is the solution of this problem and these diseases? Rasulullah gave us the solution. He taught us, عليكم بسنتي. The exit of this fitna and groups and differences is to follow the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. To love Allah, to love His Messenger, to love the Sahaba, to love Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman and Ali and Asar al-Mubashirin bil Jannah. To love the Sahaba, because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Hubbul Ansari min al-Iman." To love Ansar is a sign of Iman. "Wabughdul Ansar min al-Nifaq." And to hate, dislike the Ansar is a sign of hypocrisy. Anyone who loves the Sahaba, keep in mind that he is a mu'min, that he is a believer, that is a sign of Iman. And anyone who dislikes Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman and the Sahaba is a munafiq. Wallahu subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ. The munafiqeen will be in the lowest level of hellfire. So the Sheikh says, if you obey Allah and His Messenger, Allah will help you. وقال تعالى وعد له وعد الله الذين آمنوا منكم وعملوا الصالحات لا يستغلفنهم في الأرض كما استغلف الذين من قبلهم ولا يمكنن لهم دينهم الذي ارتضى لهم ولا يبدلنهم من بعد خوفهم أمنا يعبدونني لا يشركون بي شيئا قلت ما سمعتم فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده.